is up, YouTube? It's Melton Metal Anthony here with another one for you. I've been excited to make this video. It's been a few weeks in the making to try to get this guy his parts in order to get started on his project. It's some messed up stuff. They ran this machine into the ground. I ain't no icy well. He probably could have. He'd probably be able to do this project 10 times better than I'm about to do it. But I'm the best around here, so this ain't Texas. It ain't. It's Florida. Florida. It's raining today. Typical Florida day in the summer. But luckily, I'm going to be working in a shop or an overhang or whatever, so I don't have to worry about the rain too much. All right, let's go and let's get this done. All right, I'm here on the site. This is the culprit, the Kubota. That's Willy, the guy in the blue. I don't know who the other dude is, but Willy helps me out all the time when I do work for Rogers Landscape out here in Lutz. You guys need landscaping supplies, come check out Rogers. He's the man. Well, Glenn. All right, so this is what we're dealing with. Looks like this is a temporary repair they put on. Willy, did you just put that on real quick? Sweet. All right. So we got to fix all this here. We're gonna put new pins. Looks like we mainly need to put one, what do you call it, on there? Bushing. Right. Holy cow, that's bent.
Yeah, we got a lot of work.
All right, yeah, he made more work. It's all right, we'll get it done. All right. So here are the pins and sleeves we got machined for this project. As you can see, that's what we were dealing with right there. Completely wore out. So here I'm just heating up the arms to bend them back into place, as well as all the pins and bushings being messed up. The arms on this loader were bent into like an S shape. So here I am heating them up, using a pry bar to bend them out. So now that we've gone ahead and gotten these as straight as we can, we're gonna go ahead and burn the grease at all the joints. Willy's gonna prep everything out for me, and then we're gonna start burning the bushings on the sides, the new bushings. We'll use the existing bushings to scare it.
So, thank you. Oh yeah, I heard what you said.
What we'll need to do.
Oh, you're gonna scorch it out and put this thing down like that?
Yeah, that way it's straight. Okay. That's why I had that lip cut on, so I know it's straight.
Okay.
So we're gonna use this. As long as this is flat, it'll be straight.
Okay.
What we need to do is get the machine in here, set it in place on these two. We'll do these two first.
Yep. And you're not gonna blow that out first?
No, because I don't know how big, I don't know where to blow it out.
Right.
Until I get the pin through that and this.
Right.
So we're going to use the machine to align the pins, the new pins, the new bushings. This thing really needs new bushings inside of the bushings, I guess, on the machine. But we're going to work with what we got.
I got this fucking back.
So what you see me doing here is just marking where the bushing and the pin lined up best. I'm going to come back after this and blow that hole out with a torch. You'll see why in a minute. So I had a lint put on these when I got the machine so I can just torch cut the existing holes, pop these in, and we have our bushing, and it can ride on side of that instead of inside of the actual piece itself. So we can replace these if something goes wrong. Thank you.
Now that we've got it all aligned, we're gonna go ahead and torch this out and then weld our sleeve back in there, and that should be good. So what you see me doing here is just driving the pins in. I'm going to do that on both sides. We'll align the bushing and then go ahead and weld it out. And again, here I'm just preheating to make sure that I get a fully penetrating weld. I noticed porosity in the tacks, so I went ahead and ground these out, and I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to a 6010 instead.
Ah. don't know where we got this material. I think it might have been an old pin that we just put in the machine. So I think it was grease in the pin. Right. Or in the bushing. You sort of sure shit ain't gonna grease on what we got. Clean the fuck out. I wonder how to get it so cheap. $24. I was like, really? $400? I was like, yeah, that's a hell of a friend this guy here doing something somewhere. Probably just keep on recycling some material. It's alright, I think. It'll work just as good. It's gonna make it harder for me. So we're using 6010 to pull all that shit out. It'll sit in the slag in 6010. And after it cools a little, we'll hit with the wire wheel and pop all the slag off. The slag will keep it from cooling too fast.
I'm using the 6010 as a root pass, and I'm going to go downhill with it. When I run the 7018 cap, I'll run that upwards.
Get out of gear. Oh, Willy, I would have got out. Thanks, brother. Yeah.
Thank you.
You signed it. Thanks, Willy. Have a good day, brother. All right, guys. So we're done with them for the day. I don't think they have any work for us for a while, but that's okay. We're heading on to the next one. Some dude at a Bank of America needs some stuff torch cut. So I don't even know what he was talking about. He kind of was a mumbler. But we'll go check him out when we show up there. Hopefully he's not a fan of my YouTube and finds out I called him a mumbler. Typical rainy season. Luckily, I've been getting lucky. All the jobs this week have been indoors, so I haven't really been missing out on too much. So that's fantastic. But let's see what this Bank of America job's all about.